It's about 40 years since we hit the road to do the National Trachoma and Eye Health Program.
The significance of this trip is really wanting to see the outcomes of what was then, 40 years ago, to what it is now.
We were opening up our eyes and other people's eyes to the plight of Aboriginal health.
Aborigines were being oppressed under the Australian health system.
Real privilege to be a part of the trip, and what Ffred did and what they were able to do, and it really is very inspiring.
In 2 years, the National Trachoma and Eye Health Program was to send eye specialists thousands of miles around Australia. The permanent team was led by Professor Ffred Hollows.
It's the 1970s, it's the land rights movements gathering steam, and Ffred gets this money through the Royal Australian College of Ophthalmology to go and have a serious look at the problems of eye health in rural and remote communities.
We might try and test you for glasses to see if we might make you see a bit better, eh?
Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander people were still seen as second-class citizens in Australia. So for a white guy from Sydney to want to go out and take a team and do something about Aboriginal health, it was just amazing for his time.
So Ffred sets off with eye health workers, most importantly with a whole range of Aboriginal people who led the program.
Tell you what's it all about. So if you'd like to go and see him.
Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander people welcomed him with open arms, and because of using Aboriginal people to talk to community first and then getting their permission for him to actually come out.
And what's your name?
I've not in my life seen the extent of engagement whereby we had to speak through so many different Aboriginal language groups.
They looked into the eyes of over 100,000 people. They treated well over 25,000 people.
Hollows made headlines when he criticised the authorities for what he described as the appalling state of Aboriginal health.
They found conditions that were not unlike conditions Ffred had seen when he travelled in the Third World. And in fact, in many cases, they found conditions which were much worse.
Trachoma, that's a chronic conjunctivitis that shows signs in childhood and blinds you in middle age. There was no trachoma in white Australia. 80% of the kids in Waddy Creek had trachoma.
Trachoma shouldn't exist if you can live clean. If you can't have access to hot and cold running water, if you can't ablute, if you can't wash your clothes, if you can't wash those bugs away, then they're going to go on and get those reinfection and reinfection and reinfection.
After a number of infections, and the eyelashes turn in and it scratches on your eyeball, and it is a really horrible, painful way to go blind. They found literally hundreds of people who were blind and thousands of people who were going blind because of trachoma.
Now, just Linda, I just want to measure you up now. I want you to look at me.
It was shocking, and I was a very innocent young white Australian woman who thought I knew about my country, and I really didn't. You know, our beautiful Indigenous people were seriously having worse conditions than you would have had if you would have to call in the RSPCA.
The hard facts are that in an affluent country like this, there are incredible pockets of poverty and disease.
And because of who Ffred was, he got access to the Prime Minister, he got access to people in government. And they didn't just talk about the appalling health conditions that they found. They talked about racism. They talked about inequality. They talked about poverty in Australia.
So for me to go into remote communities, I just knew that we were doing something that would stand our community in very good stead, so it was great.
It's one of the reasons why the program was so successful, is because of the Aboriginal involvement in it.
The team is credited with halving the incidence of curable blindness among Aborigines.
It was 23 years ago yesterday when Ffred was buried here. It's what you guys started, right? You and Ffred and Gabby. What you started today is having an enormous impact.
We came to give them sight. A growly old fella. We honour him today.
What are we commemorating? We're commemorating that there was a bit of a revolution that started in the 70s. Ffred Hollows didn't start it, but he jumped on it. It was an Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander revolution saying, it's not good enough, and said, let's do something about it.
And there's yet more pressure on the Prime Minister tonight, with Malcolm Turnbull admitting the Close the Gap Indigenous Affairs program is still wide of the mark.
It's prompted calls from Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander leaders for more consultation.
Labor has promised $9 million to eradicate trachoma. Australia is the only developed country in the world where it's still a problem.
What can we learn from Ffred Hollows that might help us with the current situation? If there's anything, it's around engagement, putting the tools in the hands of Aboriginal people to make the difference.
My name's Chris Rella-Baker and I'm an ophthalmology registrar, and my background is I'm a Birragabi, Yagara, Warrumal Aboriginal man. I went into medicine with the hope that I can help other people, but for me it seemed like an impossible dream. When my school careers counsellor advised me that perhaps I shouldn't do medicine. And the reason was because at that stage Aboriginal doctors were virtually unheard of. I think we had five in the whole country.
Today we're fortunate in having somewhere over 200 Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander doctors.
But we only have one Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander ophthalmologist in training. We're hoping he will be our first Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander ophthalmologist.
Ffred would be so excited. Chris is sort of well on the way to almost completing that.
So what's going on with your eyes?
Oh, well, I got one done about 4 months ago.
Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander people know what's best for their people. They know what their customs are, they know what the protocols are. So to have an Aboriginal man operate on your eyes just gives you that bit of familiarity. It's Aboriginal health in Aboriginal hands.
Yeah, that one looks really good. A lot of the ultimate goal for him, I imagine, was to have an Aboriginal person as an ophthalmologist.
If we learn nothing else from Ffred Hollows and Gabby and the Aboriginal people who ran that program that we can bring into the current efforts to close the gap, let's learn that, you know? The lead has to come from Indigenous people, and the resources have to be put in the hands of Indigenous people.